Yeah, so we had Mike on the show out here in St. Louis. He did an interview.
Of course, man.
And he talked, it's the hometown, you know what I'm saying? And he talked about the fight with you, you know what I'm saying? But you guys have a history, right?
Yes, we do.
So tell us about the history with dude over there.
Man, the history is Michael's got me before, man. He got pre-evolution caveman, though. He don't want to talk. He knows I'm a way better fighter than I've ever been before, man. I've been wrecking people these last few fights. And we're going to see something a little different, man. I got some payback. I got some vengeance for him.
Some vengeance. So when you're fighting somebody that you took an L to, do you fight your fight? Is it more aggressive? Is it like, I have to go up from there and I got to even up the score? What's the mindset?
You know, I do like that. I did like that mindset when I'm training. When I'm training, man, like getting even, this dude whooped my ass. I got to get back at him. I got to get in there. I got to beat him up in front of his home crowd. You know, a lot of that stuff, man, like that's energy, man. That'll push you in training. But when I get out there, what I got to do is fight smart. And you got to be sharp up here. Like the best fighters in the world are always sharp right here. So being sharp and being in the right mindset when I walk into that cage is ultimately the winning factor.
What do you think you've done the first fight where you can fix and take advantage of Michael Chandler in his hometown?
Well, you know, one of the things I think, here's what it really is, man, is I've changed. Man, I am not the same fighter that fought Michael. That was the 1.0 version. This is 2.0 caveman right here. And, you know, I had to change a lot to get to where I'm at right now. I had to change a lot of trainers and the way I trained. And I had to drink diet beer. And
Diet beer?
Nah, I don't drink no beer now.
I was about to say, where do you get that at?
I know, right? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. But no, I gave, you know, my mindset has changed. I want to be a champion, so I'm willing to give up a lot more. You know, just the idea of winning has propelled me forward to this better state of mind.
Do you think the cards are stacked against you? You know, Bellator having you guys fight in this hometown, you know what I'm saying? Is it more of a, I'm really going to even up the score and I'm going to do it here in St. Louis in front of his fans, his family?
Yeah, absolutely, man. You know, it's one of those things, man. You know, I fought in front of my hometown for Bellator quite a few times, man, and you can use that energy or it can be against you. And it's all your mindset going in there. And, you know, I know Michael's ready. And if he thinks that I'm not ready, he's going to be sorely mistaken. That's the biggest thing. That's the biggest thing is, man, is if he didn't train like he's fighting a champion, then he's not ready.
So you beat Michael Chandler. What's next?
Head towards the belt by any means necessary. I'll stack bodies left and right. It don't matter. I think beating somebody who's a former lightweight champion, beating somebody who's beaten me before in the past proves a lot. So I think that skyrockets me to a greater place.
I like how you said stack bodies. Yeah. That means you're not playing. You mean business.
Yeah, I don't care.
Friday comes. Yeah. It's a problem. The caveman is in the building. You got your club ready?
Yeah, you know the club is
here. You got your club ready?
The club is here. You know, one of my favorite things to do is have fun with my walkouts. And
yeah.
I was here for the last show that they did at the Scott Trade Center, and I cannot wait to show out on that stage.